Hi, this is Desert Island Vids. I'm Eagle Spitz. Today I've got Erik from Zooparty. Hello.
Hi there. Hi there. Good to see you.
And you, mate. And you. Tell us a little bit about yourself, mate.
My name is Erik Pettersson. I live in Sweden. I live in Stockholm, Sweden since about 25 years, but I came originally from a place about a two-hour drive from here, so it's good. I play in a band called Zooparty. We've played quite a lot in England, and we released the albums on the Irish label called Deadland Records. That's about it.
You've been around quite a while now, haven't you, Zooparty?
Yeah, we've been around now. Actually, it's 15 years this year. So in November this year, we're celebrating 15 years. So we've been around for a while. Yeah.
And you was in bands before that?
Oh, yeah. Yes. We all were playing the bands before. I don't know. Maybe you recognize one of the bass player Morgan's band. It was called Chicken Pox. They play ska music. And I toured a lot in the 90s. Otherwise, the bands that me and the drummer was in, we played mostly here in Sweden. So not international at all, no.
Okay, so what's the Swedish punk scene like then? Is it still...
It's pretty good. I guess it's actually even... I don't know if it's more band nowadays and in the 70s, 80s, but at least it's much band as these times. So it's a lively punk scene. There's a lot of bands. Playing on, there's a lot of new music released, there's a lot of festivals, concerts going on, so it's a good punk scene. Obviously it's not a live scene now because we have the corona thing here in Sweden as well, but before that was quite lively. I would say it's probably more lively now, and in the 70s, 80s there's a lot of bands playing, and the really good thing is that it's not only old farts like me playing, the youngsters doing it again, so it's I'm really looking forward for the future for the Swedish punk scene. It's a lot of good bands.
Brilliant, because we need a lot of that young blood in the scene, I think.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So what kind of bands do you listen to?
I try to listen to quite a variety of bands. I mean, obviously I like the old ones from the 70s, like the Sex Pistols, the Ramones, the Damned. But the Bad Brains, the Buzzcocks, the Yugoslavs, all of those. But also like to listen to a lot of like hard rock, like AC/DC, Aerosmith, Kiss, stuff like that. And of course the originals like the Iggy Pop, the New York Dolls. So, but that was the whole thing. I really tried to listen to new stuff as well. Try to see what's going on the scene now. So if I find a new band, I try to listen to music, buy the records, and see them live before the corona stuff. So there's a few Swedish bands to really check out. There's one called, they actually have split up now, there's a band called Zooparty that was really good, and there's a band down in my hometown called TVI. You should check out those, they're really good. And what else? There's quite a few. So I try to listen to different kinds of music. I'm not trying to stuff just listen to punk or just listen to hard rock. I mean, there's an old saying from Duke Ellington, when they asked Duke Ellington, which kind of music do you play? And he said the famous word, well, there are actually just two kinds of music. There's good music and there's bad music. We play good music.
Excellent. So, quote, and Duke Ellington there, are you a jazz fan as well?
Not really into jazz, no, but I like reggae, I like ska, I like I can listen to like classic, I like the pop music on radio, I like to listen to metal music, to as I said, Kiss, Aerosmith, that's quite, I mean, like radio-friendly rock. So I mean, I like not, but not that much jazz, actually, no.
Right.
I can't actually say that because the drummer's wife is singing in jazz bands. So, of course, I liked her kind of jazz music, obviously, yeah.
I'm asking because jazz is one of my loves as well.
Okay, yeah.
But you mentioned a few bands. Would you say they've got an influence on your sound as a band?
Absolutely. I mean, of course, if you listen to us, you can hear that we really like the Sex Pistols, the Damned, the Ramones stuff is there. The band that's Steve and Paul from Pistols formed after, the Professionals. You can hear a lot of Professionals in our music. And there's, if you listen to it, you can find some hard rock stuff there as well. So yeah, there's a lot of influence, and there's a lot of influence actually from the 70s and the 80s in it. So we keep it good old fashioned punk rock music.
Cool. I mean, one of the bands I mentioned in a live review of you several years ago, I heard a little bit of a Professionals in there.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, actually, there was a friend of mine from Germany said that we have written the best Professional songs that the Professionals haven't written. So it was a great Professional songs, but it wasn't written by the Professionals. And that's a song called Raised on Boredom, or it's on our second album. And we always have play Raised on Boredom at concert. So there's a lot of Professionals in that one, yeah.
Oh, brilliant. So could you introduce your first choice of video?
Yeah, sure. The first one, let's see, was that the Ramones one?
Of course.
Yeah, I really, really like Ramones, as I said, and listened to them for a long time. I have the pleasure to see them live quite a few times when they're going on. We have played as support for Seed Ramone, and we have toured Sweden with Rich Ramone. So we have, it's been a real honor to play with those guys now afterwards. I've chosen one of the I think hidden gems, the ones called Your Sound Like You're Sick, from an album called Pleasant Dreams. Pleasant Dreams is one of their mostly underrated albums from Ramones, I think, and this is a really great song. And I also choose to have this one, as the other ones I've chosen, to be the live versions, because I really miss seeing live bands. So this is a live version of You Sound Like You're Sick. And it's the only, I mean, it's a lot of songs from that album that they only played on that tour. And then after that, the last years, they only played the KKK To My Baby Away. The other songs was no one there again. And that's a shame because it's a really good one. So I give you Your Sound Like You're Sick with the Ramones.
Which sounds quite appropriate at the moment.
Absolutely, yeah.
With COVID-19.
Yeah, there's a lot of people are sick out there, so yeah.
You sound like you're sick! What's that, Denver?
Get it again with everybody.
there a politics to a band, or what are your songs tend to be about?
In our bands, it's not politics if you talk different parties or taking stands like that. It's more politics in the way that you have to take care of each other. You have to stand up for your rights. You have to try to survive in this weird world, as we call it out there. It's a sick world. It's even sicker now in 2020. And otherwise, it's actually I got the question a few times, and as I write mostly of the lyrics, I said, "What do you write about?" And if I look at my lyrics, it's a lot of things about mental issues. It's a lot of people I know, and it's a lot of people talking about mental issues. It's a lot of stuff around that, actually. So it seems quite jolly sometimes when you hear the melodies, and it's quite poppy, but it's a depth in those lyrics, actually. Yeah, it's a lot of mental issues.
Oh, good. And why particularly mental issues are you dealing with?
I think it is important. It's really important to talk about them. There's a lot of people who are having problem with that, but it's still like you can't really talk about mental issues. It's no problem to talk about if you're broken a leg or if you have a heart issue, what can ever. But if you have a mental issue, you can't really talk about it. And that's a shame, because I think there's a lot of people needs help. And yeah. A small part of that one can actually be to talk about it and to talk it, talk about with your family and friends and let them know about it. It's a lot of people out there. So how they are, what Jake Burns said in the Stiff of the Finger song, it's a dark side to talk about it. And there's a lot of people out there. So I think hopefully we can talk about it and write songs about it. Could be a bit easier.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I'm actually a medically retired community mental health nurse.
Okay.
But I've experienced mental health issues and depression and stuff. So I totally think you're right. You know, we do need to be talking about it.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah, there's nothing worse than feeling alone within it all.
That's true, yeah.
You can't just... Anyway, I've lost my train of thought there. That's very professional. I can't listen... Let's start again. So,
okay,
let's move on to your next track.
Yeah, sure. The next one is another favorite I mentioned here earlier. It's an American band called the Bad Brains. And the first I was in contact with the Bad Brains was when I bought a comp album. I guess it was really, could it be like 81, something like that? It was an album called Let Them Eat Jelly Beans. And on that album, there's a lot of great bands on that album. But there was Page to Come was there with the Bad Brains, and it was love from the first time I heard them. I mean, they are really great. They are really fast. They were really good, and still have the great melody in it. So after that, I started to buy the few stuffs from the Bad Brains that you could buy here in Sweden. I found the Sailing On. That was a 12-inch, and after a while I found a cassette as well. So that was the start of it. And then since then I've listened to them and followed them for a long time, and they're really good. I mean, they aren't really an active band nowadays because of the split up for, I don't know, the 5th, the 10th, the 20th time. So they can't really act here, but it's a really good band. And that was really a pleasure to be into Rebellion last year, 2019, because HR, the singer, was there. And luckily enough, I had a brief chat with him and met him in. And that was one of my heroes. That was good. Good to see him. Yeah. And speaking about mental issues, he had a lot of problem with those. So it was good to see him back touring. And seems quite right, though. I think so. He seems doing fine.
Brilliant. So we'll have that song in the links, and it'll be posted within the video as well if you watch the YouTube version. I picked Let Them Eat Jelly Beans up when I was about 18. I'd be about 81, I think.
Yeah.
And yeah, that blew me away. It introduced me to a lot of really good bands. I became a big Flipper fan after that.
Yeah,
that was definitely my first hearing of Bad Brains, and such an awesome song.
It's a great song. It's a really great song, yeah. And it's a great, this video here is the same as I said before, the Ramones. It's a live video from, I think it's CBGB's in New York, and it's a great, and they were an amazing live band. And HR was probably one of the best frontmans ever. They're great.
Right, and you see HR perform at Rebellion?
Yeah. He played Rebellion in 2019. It was quite good. He played almost just reggae music. It was one of the songs that was a little bit of punky, but mostly reggae music. But I think he did it okay. It was a bit special, maybe a little bit weird, because he had a band in the States, but he didn't bring that band with him. So there was English musicians playing with him. So they haven't rehearsed for that long, but it was a good set. It was a good set. They did well.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah.
And, you've worked with other sort of quite famous punk rockers, haven't you, as well?
Yeah, that's true. About? Well, it's a long story. I'll try to make it short, but we work with Brian James from The Damned, and that started here in Stockholm when we moved, and we had some help moving the furniture. One of the guys who helped us move saw that I had a lot of records, you know, the punk records. Yeah. And he said, "Do you like The Damned?" "Yeah, of course I like The Damned. They're great." "Do you know who Brian James is?" "Yeah, Brian James is one of the greatest songwriters ever." "Well, my sister is married to him." So, and he said, and I work as a journalist. So he said, you have to call Brian, because he said, got a new album out. So I got the number, I called Brian up. We did an interview, and after that we stayed in touch. So when he had been here in Sweden a few times, and I met him here, and I of course meet him now when I'm in England. It's gonna be great, and he's a great friendship now. We've known each other for about 20-25 years now, so it's really good. So he's one of those who play on all the Zooparty albums. Another one is Glenn Matlock from the Sex Pistols. I met him briefly in 1996 when the reunion tour was, and I met him here in Stockholm. But that was the same there. I did work for a while as a UK correspondent for one of the bigger daily newspapers here in Sweden. So I was based in London. And the Glenmapton was releasing a soul album. So I got in touch with the record company. And then I get in contact with Glenn and said, sure, where should we meet? And he asked where I live, and I told him where I live, and it was just a couple of blocks away from him. So it was the same coffee place. So I met him there. And the same there, I mean, if I went to the grocery store, I met Glenn. And if I went to the pub, I met Glenn. And if I went to the Thai restaurant, I met Glenn. And that was starting to a friendship as well. So I've known him now for about the same 20, 25 years. I stay in touch. When I'm in England, I meet him. And when he's in Sweden, he's been in Sweden quite a lot, actually. We meet here. And he's playing on the albums. It's a great honor to have both those heroes of mine as friends nowadays. And they can and they play on albums. It's great. It's really mean a lot to me.
I mean, some people's experience of meeting the heroes is a bit disastrous. They turn out a bit riot twats, but you seem to be doing okay with yours.
These two seems okay, absolutely. They're really good, really friendly, and I try to respect them and they respect me. It's great. Really enjoy each other. And it's not just the name on the album. They really bring something to the music as well. Really help out with the songwriting and production and stuff. So Glenn has produced a couple of tracks with us. We went to Brighton and recorded with a couple of tracks with Brian Ames as well. So that it's not just a name on this. It's mean more than that.
Good. Yeah. I was hoping it wasn't just a name. being a DIY punker myself. So you're a journalist.
That's true, yeah.
You specialize in any kind of journalism, or
it's actually, I write and I work for a newspaper specialized in politics and economics nowadays. So it's a Swedish paper. We published all the time on the website, and the print production is out once a week. So it's pretty good. I enjoy it. It's not like a daily newspaper as I used to work. So this is more like a weekly based one, but I enjoy it. It's good fun.
Good. And have you got any stories you'd like to you could share with being a journalist?
Do you mean what I experienced as a journalist?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of them. I mean, mostly from the times when I worked at the daily newspaper, because that was quite interesting. There was a lot of crime stories I went involved in to write about. I was in England when the mad disease was a big thing in Great Britain. That was huge. I went to when the tsunami hit Thailand. There was a lot of Swedish people that was there. So I went to Thailand and wrote about that. That was a huge thing. There's a lot of things that still in my mind, the scenes I saw and stuff like that. And there's another one. Do you remember a weird guy called Josef Fritzl in Austria? Who had his daughter in a room, secret room in the basement, and they kept them there as a second family for about 20 years, something like that. Really weird story. So I was down in Austria, wrote about that. Check it out, Fritzl. That's a mean man, really, really mean man. So that was a huge thing. Yeah.
Okay. And you mentioned about mental health and some pretty heavy journalism.
And yeah.
Is there much support for journalists with mental health wise?
How do you mean that?
Well, I was thinking, there must be journalists who go into situations and end up suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder or something. And I was wondering if there's...
I would say that, I mean, when I come back from Thailand and have covered the tsunamis I was there for, I don't know, a week, 14 days maybe. And then we got some support from that, yeah. We were not allowed to stay there for too long. We have to come back. And when we come back, we had some support. We had the debriefings and we had people to talk to. So I would say, yeah. The people who are the employers who own the papers, I say they're pretty good on that here in Sweden. They try to help out when stuff like that happens, yeah. And there can be other stuff as well. I mean, there could be people who have mental issues in other ways or have problems with their family or problems at home. And I would say that they really try to help them here in Sweden.
That's good to hear.
Yeah, yeah.
The next thing that would be good to hear is your introduction to the last song. We already spoke about Matlock, haven't we?
We have spoken about Matlock, and I can't really do this without having one of the Sex Pistols songs. And the same there, I chose a live version with the band, and this is from the original lineup with Glenn Matlock in from the 1976. And when I scrolled around YouTube to find that, I realized that there aren't really a whole concert filmed with Glenn Matlock from 1976. There's a few things with Sid, and of course there's a lot of things from the reunion and so forth. It's not the whole concert, what I know about, filmed with Sex Pistols from 1976. But this one is from Manchester, and this one is Pretty Vacant. Pretty Vacant is, as you probably know, the one that, I mean, Glenn wrote most of the music, but was John who wrote most of the lyrics. Pretty Vacant, Glenn wrote the lyrics as well, most of the lyrics as well. And it's a great song, so I thought, well, why not do Pretty Vacant with the Sex Pistols from Manchester, 1976.
Brilliant. And you said you met Glenn Matlock in 96 on a reunion tour.
Yeah.
How did you... Because I went to see him on that tour, possibly the same tour, when I played in Finsbury Park in London. And part of me was wanting him to be really shit after these years. But I was... pleasantly surprised about just how bloody good they were.
Yeah, they were really good on that tour. It was really good. And they, as I said, there was a lot of people who thought it should be really bad and why should they reform? But they were really good on that tour. So I think they actually showed that how it should be played, how it should be done. Sex Pistols, the 1906, great one, really good.
Yeah, because Iggy Pop was supporting in Finsbury Park, amongst others, Stiff Little Fingers and people. But which brings me back to the original point. I mean, it's like you're talking about Matlock and James. They performed as part of Iggy's band, haven't they, together?
They did. Yeah, that's true. There was a short live. I mean, Glenn played with Iggy on the Soldier album, and he wrote some songs with Iggy in that while. But it was a short while in the live set that was, you had Iggy Pop, Glenn Matlock, and Brian James playing. That must be in 1979. The was in his band, and that's quite good because it was a great lineup, and there's a few live stuff released nowadays, not just bootlegs, even official releases from that period. And to brag about it, it's the only time Brian James and Glenn Matlock played together is with Iggy Pop and with me.
Zooparty, yeah, brilliant. So how can people get hold of Zooparty stuff and check you out? Obviously, they can't get to your gigs during lockdown, but, you know, if I want to check out your music?
Yeah, you can find us on Facebook, and you can find us on YouTube. So start with those two. And here in Sweden, Spotify is quite big. If I understand right, not all of you have Spotify in England, but if you do have, we're on Spotify as well.
And of course, This is going out on the 15th of August, which is a Doing It For The Kids festival. And viewers, you can catch Zooparty later today, as it will
be. Yeah. Looking forward to it. We're going to give you a live set there, and we're going to do our very best. So hope you enjoy it.
I'm sure we will. Thanks for your time of being on, Erik.
Thanks for having me. It was really a pleasure. Take care, mate, and I hope I'll see you soon.
Yeah, hopefully, mate. You take care. Yeah.
Okay. Bye-bye
now.
Bye.
Hello.
See you.